Hey Oakham students, Ben Azmon here. Today we're going to be doing our next purification technique, that's simple distillation. Let's get to it. Simple distillation. It's another purification method, this time for liquids. It allows you to collect one liquid by boiling off the compound and using the differences in boiling points to actually get it. Now, for us today, simple distillation is one of two kinds of distillation. For simple distillation, you work with, you separate a volatile compound from a non-volatile, usually impurity, okay? But whatever, we call that a compound, we call it impurity, it's indifferent. For the other kind, if we have both volatile, that's next week, that's fractional distillation. Link on the screen now or in the description down below. But in general, volatile for us just means kind of low boiling point. Low boiling point could be anything that's vaguely near room temperature. And even near is kind of subjective. But essentially, that these two have a big enough difference in boiling point that we could boil this off without this one coming off. For us today, we have this as our setup. This is going to be our setup. We have here our Hickman distilling head. We have a cap with a hole, we have an O-ring, and we have a conical vial. I only drew the top of that. You'll see a bit, you'll see it in a moment. But it's important to see for this. We also have two thermometers. This is unusual for this class. We do have two thermometers going. When you're assembling it, it is immensely important that you take the Hickman first, and then you put the cap with the hole on, then you put the O-ring, and then you put the conical vial, which has a screw cap. So this is one, that's two, and that's three. If you do it out of order, you're not gonna get a good seal, and things will just escape from the sides. Now, you'll notice that I have drawn here a little bit of a different colored lip on this piece of glassware. You gotta make sure that both of these pieces pass that lip, otherwise also it won't seal properly. Now for the Hickman itself, this part is inside this tube, and this part is kind of like the outside. It's that big kind of ball there. This is actually where it's going to collect. We have here, the bottom part is going to be a hot area, and here at the top is going to be cold. Cold is of course relative, so it's hot. It's cooler than hotter than the boiling point, cooler than the boiling point. We've got to keep it that way for this to work, and what we're going to see is it's going to evaporate from here, once connected of course, it's going to condense along the sides there, and it's going to collect right about there in this area. Now, a lot of organic stuff that we collect, especially today, these things will not be easily visible. You really got to kind of get down, look around, because they have similar refractive indices to that of the glass itself. Once you have collected this, we want to grab ourselves one of these guys, one of the 9-inch pipettes, and we're going to slip this down through here, suck out some of this, and put it into a vial for you to keep and measure for later. So now we do have two thermometers, one here that's going to be for the sand bath so you can monitor the temperature that the vial is going to experience, and then and we want that to be hotter than the boiling point of your compound. And then we have one in here. This is going to be to measure the boiling point as it's coming off. This isn't strictly required to do a distillation, but it is informative, and for us today we do want to find out what it is. In this case, we want to make sure that this bulb, that this blue part of the thermometer, is perfectly lined up with the edge of that circular lip there, and so that the entire blue thing is lower than the highest part of this inner glass. That way it condenses onto the bulb first before condensing on the outside and gives us the most accurate temperature. Also, please note, there's nothing stopping this hole. It is open. The thermometer goes through, but this whole space here is open. We do want to leave that open at all times so that we don't create a higher pressure situation. That will affect the boiling point, and also it will, a closed container that you heat up with a volatile liquid, that's basically a bomb. We don't want to do that either.
For this part of the experiment, you're going to need a conical vial, two different sizes. This is the 5. If you use the 5, it's going to just take longer, okay? You want to use the 3. And don't worry if you do have a little bit of brown gunk. That's just the leftover residual from this particular lab. Just make sure that you have something that's vaguely clean. If it's not coming out with soap, water, and acetone, it's never going to come out. But our next thing here is alpha pinene. Now, this is a essential oil. It's very distinctly, it has a very distinct smell and comes with a dropper, so you can just add that directly like this. Don't forget to zero out your scale before you start. It takes about 2 droppers full, so once you get to the second one, you want to kind of slow down a bit. That is close enough for me, and don't forget to record how much you took. Okay, for this you will also need a Spinvane. You can use a boiling chip, but Spinvane is usually a bit better. Make sure that you, when you put it in, it is point down, otherwise it will not stir properly. Here's our Hickman, here's our cap with a hole. And O-ring, there's actually 2 sizes of O-ring. This is the thicker one. I'm gonna try that one first. You don't know which one you need until after you try it, because it's dependent on the exact combination of your 3 pieces of equipment here. But you're gonna close that nice and tight together. In this case, it came out straight and tight, so I got the right one. If the thing is coming out at an angle, that means your O-ring is too big. And if your O-ring is popping out from the top there, then your O-ring is too small. So today, you do have 3 things to hold, so you will need 3 different things here. I'm gonna start off with 2 big and 1 small. You'll see in a moment why. But here's our first one, that's to hold our flask. Okay, it's always best to start off a little too high so you can lock that into place first. And then once it's locked into place, then you can make any other adjustments that need to happen. So now this is tight enough that I know that it will be held, and I can lower that to the solution, and I kind of vibrate that so it's nice and smooth. If in this case I do not have that much sand, so I'm actually going to go and add a little bit more. Now, in order for this to stir properly, you need to have this centered in the middle of the hot plate. You can see here it's obviously not in the center of this hot plate. I can either move the hot plate, that's usually the easiest thing to do. And I want to be perfectly in the center, forward and backward, as well as left and right. So that would be here, so I want to be a little bit more over. That would be probably the ideal position. And then I'm just going to mount the sand on as best I can. Now, to mount the 2 thermometers, you're going to need both the split cork right here, that's number 10 split cork, and the rubber stopper. You have these both in your thing, just twist them on. Always have them starting way too high. You never need to get to those temperatures. That's important. Also, notice I have both rungs near each other because I don't want to put them both on the same rung. So if they are not close enough for you, you can just bring them a little bit closer by adjusting these. For this, I'm going to use the small one here for the rubber stopper one. Always start off way too high and make adjustments later. Make sure it's tight enough to hold in place. This is the one that's going to go inside. And in this case, I can see I'm way too far forward. I'm just going to try and bring it up and align it first with the top of that. And once I'm happy with that alignment, then I can lower it into position. Okay, that looks pretty good. And now lower it. And for the sand bath thermometer, I'm going to put this one over here. Once again, I'm going to start with it way higher than I need to. I chose a big one of these. If you're using a 3-prong one, make sure all 3 prongs are holding onto your piece. and it is fully tight before you start, and then you can make adjustments. In this case, I'm actually going to put it at a slanted angle on purpose so that I can easily go like this, okay, and get as close as possible to my actual vial. And get as close as possible to my actual vial. The other thing you can do to speed this up a bit is you can grab yourself a piece of foil, fold that into six, just like that, and then find the nice clean edge that's here, and you're gonna rip into it, okay? And then you're gonna take a little bit out the center, about the size of your flask. Now you're gonna come around and slip it around. You wanna to not have it touch the thermometer, otherwise that will affect your readings on the thermometer. And you want to press that down just to trap some air. Also avoid touching or covering as much as possible the cap here, otherwise it will melt. Okay, so now that we have some collected right there, we do want to remove it. So there's the pipette. You want to stick that in here. And we can bubble that out and we can suck that in. Take our pre-weighed vial and fill that up. You're gonna have to do this a few times before all of it is done. Okay. Eventually there won't be really anything left in there and you will be able to pull it out. Start by pulling out the top thermometer, then lift this out of solution. Let this cool here because there might be more that will condense after. You can in fact see that it looks like a little bit is already condensing after again. So we're going to let that cool here and see if we can collect some more. Okay, let's get whatever little bit is left over at the end. We're not expecting much. There's always just a little bit more. Lovely. So this here is our refractive index machine. There's a few components here. There's the thermometer here, and temperature is important. Over here on the right, there is the actual knob that controls the position inside. Here on the left is a switch. Up is off. That's where you leave it when you're done. Middle is outer light on, and holding it down is inner light on. We'll see that in a moment. Now, for us right now, we're going to lower our light. We can turn that off, and we're going to open it up. See here, there's a pair of crystals. Also, make sure this door is closed. Otherwise, you're not going to be able to take a measurement. These crystals are calibrated so that you can take a measurement directly. In general, they measure how the light angle changes
as you pass from one medium to another, just like if you had a straw through water, see it kind of broken, and then you see this kind of thing. So we have here our vial of product. It has been weighed already, so we know how much we got. We're gonna need enough to cover this. That's gonna be 3 to 5 drops. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You wanna really kind of cover that as much as possible. It really only takes one drop minimum, but you kind of need more than that to make it easy. And then we're gonna close this, make sure that this is nice and covered. You see that crystal here is completely covered. And then we can raise our light source and turn it on and look through this eyepiece. Looking into our eyepiece right here, lovely. If we now focus in on that, we can see a dark horizon. What our goal is to move our knob here from the right up and down to move that dark horizon. And our goal is to get it perfectly in the middle right there. Lovely. Once we have that, we will press down on the turn off the outer light, turn on the inner light. And here we go is our ruler. You're going to read this. This is going to be your number. Now that you're done, turn it off, bring that down, open this up, wipe. These are chem wipes. Okay, spray. Wipe. Close, you're done. Don't forget to record the temperature. Here's the formula that you use to correct for the temperature. This will not be always given, but you do have to do it all the time.
That's it, you're done.